Hi there, this is Peter Upvold, and in this really short screencast I'm going to show you how to use Fluid on macOS 10 to create a site-specific browser, or SSB, and access the new Gmail iPad interface, which is really quite nice. So without any further ado, let's get started straight away. I'm going to go to my Applications folder and launch the Fluid application, which allows me to create our SSB. I need to enter the URL, which is mail.google.com, and just give it a name. I'll just say iPad. But you probably want to give it a meaningful name. And I am having some problems with Fluid, so it's actually going to do something a little strange here. But it's created my new application. If I say OK, again, I don't know what it's doing. You might not have the same problems as me, but I'll just say OK. That's created the browser, and I now just need to open that up. And I have my new application here, which I'll use every time I want to access the iPad interface for Gmail. Now, I've launched the application. You see it comes up with the Gmail login page, as I expect, but it's not actually going to use the iPad interface just yet. There's one more tweak we need to make, and that's just to go to the Applications menu bar here, and under User Agent, just select Other. And in here, you just need to paste in the iPad's browser identification, which I've got here. Now, I'll put this somewhere so you can copy and paste it rather than having to copy it manually off this video, but I'm just going to copy that text and paste it in the window here. If I say OK, and if I now reload this page, or actually tell you what, I'll quit the application and start the application back up again. Okay, now you see the login page has changed. It looks a bit more like it would look on the iPad. If I now sign in to a Gmail account, it does actually take a little bit of time to log in, I have noticed, but if we just wait for that, as you can see, we now have this really nice iPad interface. So now you can use the new Gmail iPad interface on your desktop computer anytime you want, just by creating a site-specific browser with Fluid. And you can just follow that process. You just create an SSB as normal for Gmail, and then change the user agent to the iPad user agent string. So that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching. I'm Peter Upvold, and goodbye.